Do you believe that Sunday night, Dak Prescott turns it around?
I didn't hear you. Did he turn it around? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
I thought you were locked
Jesus
in.
Jesus Christ, I asked you five
You stumbled.
Times
I didn't hear you. I'm ready. I didn't hear you. I mumbled at the end there.
Did I mumble?
I totally understood what you said.
Thank you, Boomer. Did I mumble out?
I heard you nice and clear.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
So you weren't locked in.
You weren't ready.
Did Dak Prescott what? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
That's why you think it's over. Can I go, are you ready? Are you ready? Stop asking me
if you stop mumbling.
You weren't ready.
You mumbled.
I asked you seven times,
mumbles.
Are you ready?
Mumbles. Don't mumble.
He heard me.
I didn't hear you. You mumbled.
You're sitting a foot away from me.
You said on Sunday night, does Dak Prescott
run? Sunday night.
Yes.
In your gut.
My gut right here.
Are you ready?
I'm ready, yes.
You sure?
Yes, I'm ready.
Do you believe that Dak Prescott turns it around?
Yes.
See, now that doesn't work. That
what do you
doesn't
mean?
Work.
What doesn't work?
He says yes, you say no. Now what do I do?
I would not play him on your fantasy team, no.
I got knocked out last
week. Oh, is that
week.
What this is about?
No. Governor Christie, though, has a situation. Well, he's in the semifinals of our league, and he's got a similar question, but no.
But Dak Prescott hasn't been a big fantasy player anyway this year. Like, he's not going to throw 400 yards and five touchdowns. He'll give you 202.
All right, let me go to the next question.
And no picks.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Why do you think he turns it around?
I just think that he's had a bad couple of weeks. I think he hears all the noise, and I think this team will play very hard. They're at home, and I think he's played very well at home this year.
Uh-huh.
That said, if he is sucking it up at halftime, I want to see a change.
And by the way, you ain't the only
one. That would be 10 straight quarters.
Okay, Boomer, do you think Sunday night we'll see Tony Romo?
I do.
Oh.
I kind of feel it. I just feel like it's already done, man. He's really struggled on third down against these last two. I hope that doesn't happen.
I do too.
I want him to play well. And I want to see him go all the way. I really do. I mean, I'm pulling for the kid, but I'm feeling like from Cowboy fans and from what Jerry Jones is talking about, you'll know when a change is coming.
In fairness to Jones, and I've seen him get beat up for this week, in fairness to him, he was answering a direct question that was, what needs to happen for Tony Romo to play?
Right.
What is he supposed, there's only two options there. You answer the question honestly, or you say he's not playing. You could do that. That would be lying. Because if Dak Prescott is 5 for 20 at halftime and they're losing the game, you have to make the change.
Don't you feel like the last 2 weeks it's coming and the noise
has gotten
louder? You know
what, Boomer, I didn't. Not until this week. He did not play well in Minnesota, but they won. And the feeling was, this is a special group and they will figure it out. The Giant game was different because Dez dropped some passes. He fumbled the football. He slipped down, which caused an interception. They couldn't maintain any drive. And the one time they did score, people forget, they had to go for a 4th and 1.5 on that drive on their side of the 50 to keep that drive alive.
Right. Sounds like someone's panicking.
No, I'm giving you the facts. I'm not panicking at all. I'm really not.
It's much like reruns. Everyone's going.
But going for it on 4th and 1.5 is not an excuse. That's a fact. That happened.
Frankly, I think you should always go for it on 4th and 1.5, no matter where you are in the field.
I
don't disagree.
At home.
In a lot of cases.
Under 4th and 3 or less, I don't care where I am on the field, I'm going for it every time.
To me,
but you know, think about it, at home.
Separate issue.
Mm-hmm. The exception of the Giant game the first week.
He's been great.
They scored 31 points, 28 points, 29 points, 27 points,
yes.
31 points.
And he had every opportunity for them to lose that Redskin game, and he answered the bell every single time after Kirk Cousins led.
Absolutely, he did. And that was the game before the Minnesota game.
Right.
And there's no question about that. The only thing I would say is that what we don't know, and I said this to Craig all the time, is what is he missing on the field? You know, is he missing a check? Is he missing a formation? Is he missing an open receiver? Is he not going through his progressions the way he should be? Those
sure.
are the things that we don't know. And I thought the last couple games that there was a little hesitation. You know what I mean?
Yeah, he held the ball. People talk about the pressure the Giants had. How many times did he drop back? And he had plenty of time to throw.
He held on to it.
And could not. Now maybe the guys weren't open. I don't know. But he had time to throw the ball and didn't in a lot of cases.
You know what you're hearing, Boomer?
Sports talk.
I know. We're here.
First off, that's as confident and elegant and articulate as Jerry's been in 9 years. And you know why? Because he loves his Cowboys.
He does.
I do like this team.
No, you love
them. And I happen to like Dak Prescott an awful lot.
You want to make sweet, passionate love to them.